love and light for your sister and your brother here, holding the consciousness of light for the center of light, that this is an abundant, prosperous community, that we have our divine minister, that we have all that we need here. But it takes a village to have this. You don't want to have to drive somewhere far to go to your spiritual community. Your community is here, right here in Lancaster. But it takes each and every one of you to know that this is your center, that this is your center. And whether you volunteer to do the cameras, or you volunteer to do the music, or you volunteer to do prayer afterward, clean up, set up, whatever it is, everyone that is of service gets, guess what? Service is its always own reward. And one of the things that my co-director said to me is, we can't outgive God. And being of service is so miraculous because, you know, at Agape, there's like about 418 or something practitioners at the ministry. Who did I get set up to be the co-director of my ministry with? My ex-boyfriend. Valentino. who we weren't talking to at all at the time. And what does Agape mean? Unconditional love. And co-directing that ministry, it was like we were husband and wife, king and queen. You know, it was just like, all of the pain of the relationship dissolved, and we were there to serve. And it enabled us to be friends, which is what we were always supposed to be. Friends and partners in love, and partners in service. And this is what service does. In every 12-step program, they don't just say, go to meetings. They say, take a role, be a coffee person, be this person, be that person. Why? Because it gets people to show up. When you have a service, you have a commitment to the community. But one of the things that we have to realize, that service is a commitment to ourselves. Because when we are of service, we are in integrity with who we are and who we've came here to be. The connection and being of service is not just service itself. It's our soul's contract. Did anybody see Oprah get that award recently at the Golden Globes? She got the award, and she's my mentor, I don't know if you know. So for 30 years or 25 years, every day at 3 o'clock, she gave me this great advice. And so I'm really a big fan. And so after she did the speech, which was awesome, there was Oprah the president, she's the best, right? After the speech, there were reporters and they were asking her a question. What would you recommend for an up-and-coming director? If we wanted to have success like you, billionaire, what would we do? And you know what she said? Oh, I loved it. She said that when we match our personality with what our soul came here to do, we will always be successful. She said, when we match our personality with what our soul came here to do, we will always be successful and have happiness.